Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi. Amin here with Sayyidah Masters, developing the Muslim mindset for success. Now, alhamdulillah, you know, over the last month in Ramadan, I've been putting out, like, I think I put out 3-4 videos plus podcast episodes, of course, and I really enjoyed it. You know, I miss making videos. You just sometimes have to prioritize what you're doing, what you're not doing, right, in order to get the more important things done. So I can say I probably won't be going back to doing like weekly videos, except the podcast, right? The podcast is always coming out, inshallah, every single week. I will be keeping that up, inshallah. What I want to share with you today is something that, you know, I was reminded of how nice it is to share what I'm doing with you guys. Maybe you can benefit. And so I wanted to do that again here. And so you can see here in the background, I was just doing an exercise with my family the other day, and I thought I'd share it with you and maybe you can benefit, right? So the idea is to have a mission statement for your family, right? And if you're not married yet, you don't have kids yet, then you can start with yourself actually, and you can have a personal mission statement. And this will perhaps develop over time. It doesn't have to be set in stone, like whatever you decide now is going to be the same in 5 years. But I think doing this exercise is really beneficial for you, for your vision, for your life, and really having good intentions and making those intentions something more concrete. Okay, so how do you do this? The first thing I would do is I would list out all the values that you kind of believe in, right? So don't just say Islam, right? Say specific things that you kind of want to embody in your life, right? So for example, one of the values that I put was ittiqa shubuhat, right? Avoiding the doubtful matters, right? That's something from a key hadith that the Prophet gave us. To avoid doubtful matters, right? The haram is clear, the halal is clear, and between them are doubtful matters. If you avoid them, then you'll be saved, basically. So I put that because I just felt like that's one thing from Islam, and there's so many hadith we could take from Islam, but I feel like in my life, in these sometimes confusing times with so many new issues coming up, right, that are not specifically talked about in the Quran or the Sunnah, you need to always keep that principle in mind. And so that's why I put that as one of my values, right? Another value is impact over comfort. That was it. Impact over comfort. So what that means is it tells me that that's something that I value, right? And I want to remind myself to keep implementing in my life. So when I have the choice between having more impact or having more comfort, because sometimes you have to pick between those two, I must always, in order to live up to my values, I must always pick the impact. Okay, and that will mean not spending a certain amount of money on myself, instead spending it on the impact, right? So that's an example. Let's think if I could give you just a third example. Values. I mean, I put family, right? I put family as a value. What that means is that family must always have a significant portion of my time. I must always dedicate, you know, one quarter, one third, whatever, a few hours of my day to family, right? And if I'm going to live by that value, right? And that's why we use the values, because when you're making decisions about how you want to spend your money or your time or your effort or your energy, then you need to look at those values and ask yourself, is what I'm doing or what I'm planning to, is that in line with those values? So you need to create these values, and you can just brainstorm it, and then you can select a short list of those values. So I think I ended up with probably 10 to 15 values. You might start with 20, 25, and then narrow them down to what really defines what you're all about. And by the way, if you're not married yet, this I think is a good exercise to kind of, I know it's a bit weird for a lot of people, it's a bit over the top for a lot of people, but I genuinely think it still is useful. When you are looking to get married and you want to communicate what you're all about, then say, look, I spent half an hour thinking of my values and the values that I have now in my life, and also values that I already have, but I'm really aspiring to keep in my life. This is what I'm all about, right? And you can show those values to that person, and they will understand what you're all about. And then maybe they'll do the same, and you can really understand each other. Because like I often say, marriage is more about compatibility in values rather than compatibility in chemistry and sense of humor and things like that. So that's the first step, is to lay out all your values. The other thing I did, which is right there behind me, but I don't think you can read it, is I listed the role models that I have. People that I might not want to be exactly like them, but the certain elements of their ideology, of their methodology, of their just mindset that I really like and I want to take on board. Okay, so for example, I put Mufti, for example, Mufti from Hadith Disciple. He is one of my role models. In what way, right? Because it's not always going to be you're going to take everything from somebody, but there's something very valuable I feel in Mufti, in that He's somebody of the people, I feel. He's not somebody up there, you know, head in the sky, not aware of what the average person is doing. No, he's doing his dawah, he's with the people, he's doing a lot of Q&A, finding out the issues people are dealing with, and he's very aware of the imperfect situations people are in, and because of he's aware of that, he tries to give them real life solutions rather than being up there. So that's, for example, one thing I like about Mufti, and the fact that also he's quite independent. He's not dependent on any organization inviting him to give lectures or anything like that. He does his own thing, and he doesn't need to quieten himself down and censor himself to please anyone. He's independent. So, for example, that's something that I like about Mufti, right? In terms of his mindset, his way of doing things, his method, right? Another person that I really like, maybe you don't know them, is Iyad Qunaibi, right? So he's somebody, he's Jordanian. He makes a lot of videos on YouTube, and he's very in touch with the Sharia. He knows the Sharia very well. He knows philosophy very well, and thought, right, in general. And then he also knows sciences, right, and how the world works, kind of thing, how the economy works, how thingy, like, I think he's a trained pharmacist, right? So him and another person called Ahmed al-Sayyid, Sheikh Ahmed al-Sayyid, same kind of thing, where they know philosophy, right? They know liberalism and how it works and where it came from. They know the Sharia as well, and they know how the world works. I really feel like those three things work well together and allow you to really have a strong impact. So I put those two people down because of that reason, right? It doesn't mean I'm going to copy them and everything, but I noticed that. I only put, I think, one non-Muslim on the list, and that was Tim Ferriss, because I just love Tim Ferriss's approach to learning, constant learning, how to learn quicker, how to have optimized lifestyle, basically, and constantly be doing experiments to improve bit by bit. So I like his approach to that. So like I said, as an example, I like that from him. Obviously, I don't like the kufr side of him. I don't like other things that he does or he believes. But that part of him, I really like that. And I put that in my list of role models, kind of thing. So that's the second thing. Then from doing this exercise, the values and then the role models, you can create a kind of sentence. It should be really one sentence. It could be a long sentence, but one sentence which explains your, describes your mission in your life. Now, if you're doing it for yourself, it will be for yourself. If you're doing it for your family, it could be for your family. So I did it for my family. So that might be different from the mission that I might have for myself as a person, individual kind of thing. So yeah, and then you've got that. Then you could put it on a piece of paper. That's what I'd recommend. So at the top, you'd have your mission statement. Then you'd have all your values. And then you might have the role models listed at the bottom. Print it on a paper, put it on your wall, frame it if you like, whatever. And just remind yourself of these things. You know, am I living according to those values that I chose, right? I chose then. Before my desires came, before my, you know, laziness came, whatever, those are the values that I said I want to aspire to live up to. And then you've got it there as that reminder, and that mission is constantly there. So I think it's a really good exercise. It's the kind of thing that I do with businesses as well, and it really helps businesses. So why not do it for yourself? I was kind of inspired to do this from what I kind of do with businesses, but also from the book. There's a part in the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People where he talks about doing this kind of exercise. So it's those type of places that inspired me to do this. I really find it valuable. I'm happy I did it. I feel good that I did it, alhamdulillah. And yeah, I just want to share it with you, because as usual, I learn things, I do things, and then I share it with you, and maybe you'll benefit. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Just a little update on the campaign I was doing over the last month on Launch Good for the book that I'm putting out. So alhamdulillah, we smashed past the last goal. So I left the goal at £2,000. I thought anything beyond £2,000 is really good. And alhamdulillah, we ended it on £2,500. So really amazing. May Allah reward all of you. Even if you made dua for it, or if you shared it, then that is very, very valuable as well. So I really appreciate that. I made dua for all of you who, you know, who tuned into the live streams, who gave the videos likes and these kind of things. I really appreciate all of that. And especially, of course, the people that contributed with their du'as and with their money as well. So inshallah, I'll be working on that in the next few months, and really excited for that. And yeah, the campaign is still there. If you know anybody, like, you could still technically pre-order it. I left the campaign like open, even though I'm not going to be promoting it anymore. So I guess I'll put a link in the description for you if you want to check it out. And yeah, so this has been a video. Like I said, I missed it. I'm glad to be making a video. See you around, inshallah. And remember, I'm always around on the podcast, inshallah. I'll be putting out weekly episodes, bidnir rahman. Assalamu alaikum, and see you around.